WCW Saturday night. Along with Dusty Rhodes, the American Dream, I am Tony Schiavone. 1 hour right before Braves baseball of the superstars of WCW. And Dream, as we saw at the top of the program, there's a lot going on in WCW, especially when you say the two names, Roddy Piper and Ric Flair.
Well, not only did we have such a blockbuster event coming up on pay-per-view at Bash at the Beach, but bottom line, when you're talking Rodman and Hogan, Hollywood, if you will, the Johnny Luger now added to the fray, to the mix. Piper, Flair, you know what, Tony? There was eras that, I mean, I'm talking about big eras, when you mentioned these two guys' names against each other and people would have bet against them, you know what I mean?
That's right.
Well, brother, it's happened. It's among us. It's on us right here. A lot to talk about on Saturday night.
The opening bout is going to be for the WCW Television Championship. Steven Regal, the champion, will face his former tag team partner and former television champion in Bob Eaton. Fans, this morning on WCW Main Event Wrestling, we announce the blockbuster match, Ric Flair and Rowdy Roddy Piper, based on what happened this past Monday on Nitro, and you're going to see it later on in the control centers. They have signed now to face each other one-on-one at Bash at the Beach. That added to the already spectacular card, headlined by Hollywood Hulk Hogan and Dennis Rodman, two world champions together, one-on-one. Never before in the history of our sport has there been so much attention on a tag team match like the one we have coming up at Bash at the Beach.
Well, Tony, it's the players, and you've been around long enough to know that the players make the game. And this is a case where the Giant and Luger go right for the task, facing somebody that's used to pushing big guys around but isn't a wrestler. But Hollywood Hulk Hogan still is the man to deal the cost. What an event that's going to be. Piper, Flair, we mentioned that matchup, and a lot of people are saying real quick, this is a great matchup right here, because Eaton knows him well. But it real quick is, well, Flair's doing it for a horseman, but he's still friend. Flair to me has always been that coveted snake in the grass, as I've always called him. And Piper better open his eyes, because he ain't going to have to just deal with Flair, you know what I mean?
You'll have to deal with the horseman, you're right. Bob Eaton getting some right hands into Steven Regal, and Regal down to the mat hard. Eaton, well known in the wrestling ranks, is one of the heaviest hitters. Solid right hand, and he certainly has not only a great right hand, but he's hitting the man with purpose. You can go back to the days of the tag team called the Blue Bloods, and the split they've occurred since then. Regal backpedaling now. And Steve Regal has a singlet on. A little bit different look for him this week. Single leg pickup now, and sending Bobby Eaton down. It's always good, Dream, and I know you would agree, to ground Bobby Eaton. He's such a great high flyer. If you keep him down, work on the legs, that combats his primary weapons.
Well, Tony, one thing, too, we got to look at when looking at this matchup, everybody knows it's no secret. Eaton has been a little inactive as late, so we might see a little rust on him. You know what I mean? It's like a great fighter defending his title all the time and a fighter defending his title 1-7, 6-7 months. Now, Steve Regal, on top of his ball game, singlet or not, the rust showing through, I really believe, on Bobby Eaton right now. You know, because he was so active. 250 days a year, there was an era where Bobby wasn't going. They were world tag team champions, had it all going. That's all I'm saying. That's my analogy of what's happening here. Regal, unless he makes a mistake, shouldn't have a big problem with Eaton. But Eaton can beat you at any time. That's the deal.
Regal, so many ways to hurt you that time. Holding the arm and the wrist back and stomping on the elbow. And there's his patented European uppercut. One of the top high-impact maneuvers you'll find in the sport. And now trying to kick Eaton right out of the ring, back of the head. And the warning coming from Mark Curtis is because he's holding the ropes as well. And there's a big left hand in the side of the head. Actually glanced off to the nose of Eaton. And a snap pair takeover in this telecast, fans. Conan is here. Ming will be here. Rath and Mortis and Joey Maggs is here. Joey Maggs has come out to watch this match. What's that about?
I think he needs to watch every match he can, because the learning process for Joey Maggs, he's lost a lot more than he won. And the bottom line, he needs to understand how to get to that pay window, and that's good. Watching guys do this.
Yeah.
Watching tapes of that.
I would
now
agree.
Is there a tape anywhere on Dennis Rodman wrestling that the Giant and Luger can watch? No.
No, there's not. That's a good point.
Sometimes the unknown is the unknown. You know what I mean? You can't go on the street corner. My brothers at the airport when I was leaving for Philly yesterday said to me, They weren't talking about Holyfield and Tyson. They were talking about Rodman and Hollywood Hulk Hogan.
Yes.
And this pay-per-view. You know, I say you can't get that pay-per-view in that cab. You're going to have to get out and go to your house and get it. And they say, you're right, Dream. We do it all the time. Like 10 people, you know what I mean? They get them all over there.
No,
everybody going to be watching it, brother.
Right now, Regal is on the outside, and Bobby being held up by the referee. And that was a critical error on the part of Bobby Eaton. That enabled Regal to grab the leg, use the ring post, and now get the advantage. And now, Regal tying up the legs, going for the Regal stretch, and he's got it on. Lord Regal has it on.
Yeah. Eaton trying to fight it, get his arm underneath, get that leverage out of that, but now he got it hooked real good. Started with that turnbuckle, that leg whip in there. Now them, look at him, flat hands right to the forehead.
Right to the forehead, is right pulling back now.
Yeah, he's a tapping. Somebody needs to understand here that I thought he tapped out.
Three taps means it's over. He's trying to hold on. There he goes. He's tapping right now.
Yeah, yeah.
It is over. Steve Regal wins. He is still the television champ, and he's still holding on. And, well, Joey Mag's very dejected.
Well, Joey's been in that spot.
Yeah, maybe disappointed that Bobby lost the match. Maybe there's a friendship there we're unaware of. And your winner is Steve Regal. And here it is again one more time, Dusty Rhodes.
Lost Steven Regal came in with what I said was a rusty Bobby Eaton because of inactivity, but I can always be able to go ahead and put you away at any time. The Regal stretch right here. Bobby Eaton going to tap out. He fought it as long as he could. He held on. Lord Steven Regal, no longer the Lord. Now Steven Regal, new tights. Joy Mag discussed it, but it's Saturday night. We just got paid. Going to be hot.